Welcome to the Dam Owner Academy, brought to you by the Association of State Dam Safety Officials, or ASDSO, a series of videos to educate and inform on all aspects of operating and maintaining a dam safely. This video will cover public safety at dams. Although most dams serve critical purposes of water conservation, flood control, and hydropower production, there are also important areas for recreation. Swimming, boating, fishing, and other recreational activities come with inherent risks, but owners of dams can be held liable for injuries or accidents that occur at their facilities. Most dam safety regulations focus on structural integrity and the possibility of dam failure. However, it is critical that the design, operation, and maintenance of a dam also keep the safety of the public around the facility at the forefront. This video will cover a few of the prevailing hazards associated with dams and how such dangers can be mitigated. Dams are not generally designed for access by the public, but that doesn't mean people won't often interact with these structures. Many dams have slippery surfaces, confined spaces, heights, and uneven terrain. In addition, many dams have mechanical and electrical equipment that can present a hazard. A primary component of keeping the public safe around a dam is minimizing access to the structure when appropriate. Fencing and gates should be installed anywhere an unauthorized person might enter the facility. In addition, signs should be standardized and clearly mark areas that are not designed for public access. Video surveillance can act as a deterrent, as well as provide valuable information that can be used to improve safety and security measures. Dams often create swift and turbulent currents near intakes, spillways, outlets, and tail races. Unfamiliar swimmers and boaters can be caught in these unsafe conditions before they realize the hazard. Exclusion booms, upstream and downstream, can reduce access and exposure of boats, canoes, kayaks, and swimmers to swift and unpredictable flows at dams. All security measures and signage should be standardized and inspected annually to make sure they're in good condition. The most significant cause of fatalities at dams is a submerged hydraulic jump. This phenomenon occurs primarily at low head dams, small structures that span the width of a river or stream and allow water to flow over the top. These structures often seem innocuous and even inviting. However, under certain conditions, the high velocity flow over a dam can create a current that recirculates at the downstream toe, trapping anything caught in the current. This is sometimes called a keeper hole or drowning machine for obvious reasons. It can be nearly impossible to escape. Counterintuitively, the best way to exit is by swimming to the bottom and washing out of the circulation. But disorientation and debris often hinder a victim's ability to find a way out. Even first responders have been lost trying to rescue a person caught in a submerged jump. Owners of low head dams must be especially mindful of the hazard posed by submerged jumps, and specific safety measures are prudent. Standardized signs with warnings should be posted near the dam and well upstream to notify paddlers and swimmers of the hazard. Low head dams are notoriously difficult to see from upstream, so paddlers need ample time to avoid them. To the extent possible, signs should have specific warnings such as dam ahead or drowning danger, rather than generic messages like keep out. Signs should be sized for legibility at a distance. FEMA has standards for such signs, but a good rule of thumb is 3 inches of letter height for every 100 feet of distance. So a sign visible from 300 feet should have letters with at least 9 inches in height. Buoys or booms upstream can help reduce the chance of boaters unknowingly entering hazardous areas. Portage routes should be established and clearly marked so that boaters know where it's safe to put in or take out. Generally, portages should be at least 300 feet from any dam, spillway, or powerhouse. If warnings are disregarded regularly, coordinate with local law enforcement to help discourage unsafe practices. Rescue products, such as throw ring buoys, can be installed for use in emergency situations. Dams equipped with gates or controlled outlets can cause sudden changes in flow and water level. Before making significant releases from a dam, conduct a warning patrol to ensure there are no boaters or swimmers in the area. Pre-release audible sirens and lights can also help warn people of changing conditions upstream or downstream of a spillway, powerhouse, or outlet. Warnings only work if people are familiar with their meaning, so signs should be used in conjunction with lights and sirens. One of the most effective ways to keep the public safe around a dam is education. people often underestimate the hazards associated with recreation near a dam. Social media campaigns, public service announcements, open houses, booths at local events, and outreach to recreation outfits and schools all help foster respect for the hazards associated with dams and encourage safe practices on waterways. Record incidents that occur at your dam to identify gaps or flaws in existing safety and security measures. Past reports from news sources or dam safety archives can also provide opportunities for improving public safety. In some cases, it's appropriate to retrofit or remove a dam to reduce or mitigate its hazard to the public. Structural improvements or removal require input and analysis from a qualified professional engineer with experience in dam modifications. In addition to regulatory review, any project to modify, retrofit, or rehabilitate a dam should include input from recreational stakeholders, including fishermen, paddlers, boaters, hikers, and first responders. Incorporating feedback from the people who interact with the structure can help ensure that public safety is carefully considered at each step along the project process. All dam owners should take the time to evaluate the specific risks and hazards posed by their structures and implement measures to protect public safety. Every dam is different, so there is no one-size-fits-all solution to reducing dangers posed by dams. The Association of State Dam Safety Officials has free resources available to help owners operate and maintain their dams safely. Contact your state dam safety program for additional help, and be sure to check out ASDSO's website at damowner.org for more information.